Batman Soul of the Dragon is an Elseworlds tale. It is a story that is basically a love letter and homage to everything 70s. So the opening sequence has a sort of James Bond-esque intro. The entire movie is a period piece. There's a nice homages to literal Bruce Lee films, like scenes, everything 70s from blaxploitation to martial arts films. So this was kind of like a movie that definitely, you know, intrigued me because I like the concept. But basically it's about Richard Dragon. He's a martial artist who is fighting a cult, the cult of Cobra. They wish to do something terrible. So he's got to get the gang back together, and the gang comprised of Bruce Wayne, who is Batman. He lost his parents and he runs a nightclub in the city. And there's Lady Shiva, she's a crime boss. And then there's also a few others, because all of them were students of O-sensei and Nanda Parbat. So the beginning of this movie is a little bit choppy because we're starting off in the present day. Richard Dragon is trying to recruit all of the old students, and then we cut back and forth between the old students and how they, you know, learn. There are six of them, and basically they're living in this like sort of valley in a mystical, you know, in the Himalayas, a magical place where they can learn to hone their amazing martial arts skill. So there's a nice, you know, introduction. You know, we all know Bruce Wayne, Batman, and we know Richard Dragon, Lady Shiva, but there's also Jade, Ripper, and Ben Turner. So there's like a bunch of characters. And so in the flashbacks, we sort of get the story, backstory of, you know, how all of them are related. And in the present day, they're trying to stop this cult from doing something, you know, monstrous that will change the face of the planet. So overall, the movie is interesting. It's a very fun sort of just martial arts, kapow sort of little touch of supernatural stuff going on. It's very fun. It's well animated. Definitely like the voice acting and the character development. But for me, the one thing that I loved about this film is that it finally gets the portrayal of Lady Shiva correctly. If you're unfamiliar, Lady Shiva is one of the deadliest martial artists in the DC Comics universe. Probably top 10, definitely probably top 5 even. But whenever she's portrayed in an animated thing, she's so lame. Because she always gets knocked out by like someone lame, like Deathstroke's wife or something in the last animated thing she was in. Or she's like a henchwoman in Public Enemies, Batman, Superman, Public Enemies. Or in the comics, she's like one of the deadliest people alive. You know, when someone hires her to kill you, you're dead, basically. She's probably better than Deathstroke, I would say. She's been training, you know, ever since. There's only like a few characters that could probably match her, like her own daughter or, you know, Constantine, Drakon. But like in the comics, I've read a lot of comics, and she's really great in the comics. But whenever she's shown in an animated medium, she's always super lame. She's either a cameo or she's tabled really quickly. She's a lightweight, but not in this movie. In this movie, Lady Shiva is sort of like the older sister sort of badass. She is obviously the best at fighting in the group. So, you know, we get to see that in the flashbacks, but we also get to see that in present day. You know, whenever she's on screen, she kicks ass, like majorly. And, you know, they get the fun sort of boss battles with different martial artists and really cool moments. She actually feels like a deadly force. She feels like she could probably whip the entire team by herself. And she's definitely the best one there. You know, it's not because she's the oldest or she's been there, Nanda Parbat, the longest. It's because, you know, Lady Shiva is just a force to be reckoned with. And finally, we get a movie where she actually gets to do stuff. She, you know, you feel like nothing on the planet could actually fight and defeat her. It's, you know, I've been waiting for a sort of, you know, a great portrayal for the longest time. And this movie delivered. You know, obviously this movie is a bit different because in the group, a lot of the characters in the DC universe are usually villains. Like Ben Turner is Bronze Tiger. I think he's a villain. And so is Lady Shiva. She's, you know, not really an anti-hero. But in this movie, they are sort of anti-heroes because they're teaming up with Batman in order to defeat the supernatural threat. So if we're going to talk about some cons of the story, I guess the main thing is that Batman's barely in this movie. I mean, he is Bruce Wayne in this movie. He did go to Nanda Parbat, and he you know, is Batman, but he's, you know, he only has like maybe a couple of scenes here and there, to be honest. It feels like Batman Assault on Arkham, where the movie's more about the Suicide Squad than it is about Batman. But they're not going to call it Suicide Squad Assault on Arkham. They're going to call it Batman Assault on Arkham. So this, you know, Batman Soul of the Dragon, the main character really is Richard Dragon, and which is weird because he's back to being Asian, or they changed him to be Asian even though he's white in the comics. I don't know what that was about. I guess it was a diversity thing. But the voice acting is still good for everyone, and I really like the story. It's really fun. It's action-packed. The beginning's a little choppy, you know. But overall, great portrayal of Lady Shiva. There's a nice chemistry between all the characters. There's plenty of character development. And overall, it was just a blast from beginning to end. I really enjoyed this Elseworlds tale, and I give it an 8 out of 10.